Good evening, and thank you for tuning in to City Kids Making a Difference. This evening, when you see that screen say City Kids, you might wonder if I should have my head examined, because there's going to be a difference this evening. And it's not just kids that you think of about maybe in high school or middle school or even elementary school, but we're going to take that even farther out in age brackets. So this evening, though, I would like to go right to Anthony Shade, the junior host here. He's been with us quite a bit, and he's doing a super job. So I'm going to introduce Anthony, and then he can take it from there. Anthony, good evening.
Thank you, Dave. Why don't we start off by introducing our guest tonight? First, in my far end, we have Isabel Fick. She's a teacher's assistant at Northeast Middle School. And then next here, we have Michelle Moretz, the new vice principal at Northeast Middle School. And then we have Brandon Grube. He's a 10th grader at Renninger High School. And we have David Seltzer, a 7th grader at Northeast Middle School.
All right, well, before Anthony, before you start the questioning here, as you can see, we have some older ages and some younger ages. And my plan was this evening to think about how city kids make a difference, but beyond the years of high school and even college. And when I got to speaking with Mrs. Moretz and also Mrs. Fick, we had a very interesting conversation. And that's why they're sitting here this evening. So Anthony, we got some questions to ask, don't we?
Yeah. Okay, so why don't we start off with Ms. Fick again. Could you tell me about yourself?
Sure. I'm married to my husband, Michael. I have two children, Danny and Amy. I have three grandchildren, Sam, Max, and Lucas. And I've been an educational assistant at Northeast Middle School, my old alma mater, for 33 years.
And Ms. Moretz, can you tell us about yourself?
I grew up here in Reading. I was able to attend 13th and Union. I went to Northeast Middle School. I went to Reading High School, was married at Nativity Lutheran on 13th Street as well. I worked at Wise Markets. I took a few classes at Albright College and was lucky enough to come back and work at Reading Intermediate High School, and now I'm an assistant principal at Northeast Middle School. I have one son named Tim, and I have a granddaughter, Briella.
And how about you, Brandon?
I'm Brandon Grube. I'm a 10th grade student at the Reading Senior High School. I've done all of my education on 13th Street, 13th and Union, Northeast, the intermediate high school, now the senior high school, and I hope to go to Albright for business.
And David, tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm a 7th grader at Northeast Middle School. I play football for the Berks County Outsiders. I have one sister, Brianna Seltzer. My parents' names are David. I'm a junior, so David and Jamadi. And I also play basketball for Reading Youth. That's about it.
And as you can see, he has a football shirt on for the Outsiders. Why don't you tell us a little bit about what position you play, how football is?
I play quarterback. And I lead the team, so they look up to me. They respect me. We don't play Berks County, like around Berks County. Like, we don't play Exeter and Wilson. We go outside. We play Philly teams. So. Yeah.
And the interesting part about that is David is in my classroom, and we were talking about the show and about coming on this evening. And when he said about being the leader, I sort of squeezed it out of him and saying, hey, you know, you're a leader. Maybe some guys are even bigger, like the linemen and some of the bigger guys. So how do you get them to follow you? And he goes, they respect me. And I think that's really an honor to see a young man in seventh grade to take that respect and be able to lead the team as a quarterback, but also maybe in what you do as a role model off the field.
And do you think you made an impact on anybody else by being a football player, being a quarterback? Do you think you inspired anybody else?
Um Well, as a quarterback, I was the only one that played quarterback at that time. Well, before we started, and then there was two other kids that really didn't want to play quarterback, but then they saw me lead, so now they joined on to the quarterback spot. Like, they were just running backs, and now they see lead and how everybody looks up to them, so now they want to be the quarterback so they can have the attention and leadership.
And how about school? How about your class? Are you doing good?
Yeah, and I'm also in E Club, Environmental Club, and I also help people there, the new people that don't really know the cleanup crew. They don't know how to clean the milk buckets after breakfast and do other things because they're new. So I tell them how to do it, and they learn off of that.
Brandon, now you went through this a few years ago. He was on this show when Mr. Shorn was the host, and I was on with him. And I think I recall that you were like fourth grade?
Fourth or fifth grade, yeah.
So now you are now 10th grade. So can you share some of that time lapse of fourth to 10th grade and what you've done, just like David did? And again, you'll see this evening as we go up the line, there's going to be a definite difference of what they've done over their careers, younger to the older. So, Brandon.
First off, starting out at Northeast, 6th, 7th grade, I did Environmental Club, and I hope that I made an impact there. 8th and 9th grade, I continued to come back, and during 9th grade, I was in the JROTC program and did a lot of leadership help there.
Okay, and do you have anything this year that you started with as 10th grader? Do you have anything coming up?
Joining the bowling team this year, and I'm continuing to come back to Environmental Club and help out there.
Very nice. If I can, Anthony, I'm going to go to Miss Moretz here. Would you like to share now, again, like I said, we're kidding about this earlier, but now there's a definite difference in ages here, but what have you done, like, over the years, what was some of the things that you've done that you feel like, listening to these two gentlemen, the impact you made or what you did in your younger?
Well, I enjoyed playing basketball and also volleyball when I attended Northeast. I also played the flute and was part of the music program. At the high school, I was involved in German club. I switched from the flute to the tuba, was involved in marching band, and it was a different switch. It was a lot of fun to play the tuba. I also played basketball, and then I took my first job at Wise Markets down the street. I had a print shop teacher who really made an impact on my life. I ended up going to Millersville for technology education, industrial arts, and then taught for several years, wood shop, metal shop, printing, and then decided to move into administration. So I'm trying to give back to the community now. I'm involved in Squires Club as a treasurer. I am on the Northeast Alumni Board and the Alumni Association of Reading High School.
All right, and Mrs. Fick, will continue with you, the same idea.
Well, I went through the Reading schools. I became an educational assistant 33 years ago, and I think I made an impact on some of the children that I worked with because many of them come back and visit me, and also they come up to me on the street and give me big hugs and say they miss me, so that's a good thing.
And I do see that too.
Yep.
I actually visualize that and see it.
Yes.
And Ms. Fick, what is the most rewarding part about your job?
Well, I guess it's the fact that I get to work with children that need a little extra help, and then I see what that help does to help them move on to the next level.
And would you like to tell us about maybe one experience that stands out in your mind about helping someone?
Okay. I have a dear friend who was diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease, and I felt very blessed that I was able to help with her care when her family needed help.
I'm going to go back to the two young men here. Now, you're just starting your careers as middle school, going into high school. Is there one person You don't want to say the name, that's okay, but is there one person you can think of in your mind that made an impact on you? Now, we're talking about them making an impact on children. Is there one that makes stands out in your mind? Brandon, we'll start with you. Do you have someone that did that?
First off, all of my middle school teachers did that, but there was one administrator specifically at the intermediate high school, Mrs. Schubert. She helped me a lot through my ninth grade year, and I saw her as an extremely great role model, an amazing educator and administrator.
Okay, very nice. And David, how about you?
Well, you are, kind of.
I didn't pay him to say that either.
Like when I came to the middle school, first day in sixth grade, two kids come to my class saying, oh, come here, come here, come here. And I was like, what is this? And he's telling me all this stuff for environmental club, and I didn't get it at first at all. And then over the school year, he taught me about the environmental club and to be a better person and take better care of the world and to help other people.
Thank you, David. Anthony, do you want to take it from there?
Well, let's go back to Miss Moretz. Well, what impact have you made on someone else?
I think I've made an impact on a lot of students and parents, helping to solve some different concerns that have come up, and also helped support students in being successful. One of the best things I have found with social media is the amount of students that I'm able to keep in touch with today. Hearing what they're doing and hearing from them what was helpful. I enjoy that a lot.
And like I asked Ms. Fick, what's the most rewarding part about your job?
Working with the families and the teachers and the students. It's really, and the community. I like working with everyone to see how we can come together to help the students be very successful and what they'd like to do in their future, finding ways to help support them.
I'm going to sort of cut in here, and this is not on the script, ladies, because they wanted the script earlier, and I can understand that. But if you would have one day that you could be, and I'm going to ask the two young men this too, if you could have one day that you would be involved with helping others, what would it be? What would it look like? Where would it be? Maybe I should have given it to him earlier.
Well, I think I enjoy very much what I do every day. I couldn't see myself
in the classroom
anywhere
or
else.
I
do like being in the building with the students, and I like to get into the classroom, see what they're doing, asking questions. Right now I'm doing a lot of observing, but I like to be right in there. I would say another area that I really enjoyed was working, not necessarily in the Reading School District, but working with the Technology Student Association and seeing the students take the information that we had done in the classroom to competitions. And it's neat to see how they learn it and how they use it later in their life as well. But I would have to say doing exactly what I'm doing.
Okay. So. David, we'll go with you. What's one way you would see yourself as doing something, volunteering, helping someone? Where would it be? How would it look?
Mostly in the environmental club. I get to go, because last year I had to listen to the seventh graders, but now since I'm up there, I get to tell everybody what to do. I get to teach them. And then after school, I get to go to practice and lead the team. So.
And I have to say, David is a true leader at this point. I can see that. Brandon.
If I had to choose one place to be to try to help make a difference, that would be in the schools, because all my life, schools has just been a big part of me and what I've become, and I wouldn't imagine me helping anywhere else.
And Mrs. Fick?
Yeah. Well, my perfect day would be where everyone respected everyone and everyone worked to the best of their ability, and our job would be so much easier.
Mm-hmm. All right, and I'm going to stop for a minute and come to Anthony and put him on the spot, because Anthony has been with us, I think we talked about 2.5 years now, and those 2.5 years I watched him not just physically grow taller than me, But we also saw a lot of growth in you over the years, and you started as like the little sixth grader that came to Northeast, somewhat like David said about last year with him. And I've seen you really grow. What are some of the things that happened to you since the sixth grade to the 10th grade year? And I know I'm putting you on the spot, but if you can just tell us some of the things that happened to you.
Well, I really matured a lot, and like going through different schools and basically like seeing different opportunities, it just made me think differently, I guess. And yeah.
And Anthony was always the type that would try to find a different sport, a different activity. And you did. You stuck with Environmental Club and you did a lot of things with us at school. But I watched him grow into that, and watching these two do the same thing. Well, and you were the same grade, really, Brandon. But I watched you grow into finding your niche, finding your way and what you want to do. Mm-hmm. And that's what we have to do. And that's being good role models and good leaders. So back to you, Anthony.
Well, I mean, let's start with Ms. Fick. Is there anything you'd like to say to the home viewers?
I want everyone to encourage their children to do the best that they can be and to realize the value of a good education.
Ms. Moretz?
I would agree, but I would also like to ask anybody who would be willing to volunteer to let school know, because we can always use volunteers in the school system. And we look forward to working with them.
Brandon?
I just hope that if there's any children watching, that they value education that they're receiving, because it truly is something that you should not take for granted at all.
And David?
Just respect each other and don't be a follower. Don't be a follower and lead. Help everybody else around you.
All right, and let's talk a little bit about, since we have a little bit of time yet, let's talk about, and we'll ask all of you again, what are some of the things that you see that you're looking forward to in the next few months? And I know it's hard, we just started a school year for those that are in school and education. It's hard to really go too far out because things happen. But Dave, we'll start with you. What are some of the things you're looking forward to in school, out of school?
In school, I want to become the president for the Environmental Club. So I just want to get up there, because now I realize that Environmental Club is more than I thought it was last year. And
how about outside of school?
Outside, I would like to do more for the city, like go into more clubs and other things that I can help throughout the whole city.
Okay, Brandon?
Right now I'm looking forward to getting more involved with business courses within high school, since that's what I want to take into college, and then get more involved with the studies with some of my AP and honors classes, and hopefully pass the AP exam in the spring.
And before we move on, what's one of your goals maybe outside of high school? Because you are getting closer mm-hmm. to thinking that way, and these are the years that you start to debate what profession, what kind of track do you want to take. What are you looking to do when you get out of high school?
I'm not quite sure in what field, but business for sure.
Mm-hmm. All right. And Anthony, before we go to Ms. Moretz, how about you? Do you have a goal or a plan? I know you're in 10th grade as well.
Well, my dream career will be to be in the military. And I don't know what specifically in the military, but yeah, that's really what I want to do.
So you'd be a career man?
Yeah.
Career person? All right. And then back to Ms. Moretz.
I'm looking forward to seeing all the new activities that are happening at Northeast, whether it's Lego Robotics, what you're doing in the Environmental Club, the Albright football players that have come down to work on the lockers up on the third floor, and what our kids are going to be doing with those. Music program. There's so many exciting things going on in our building that I'm looking forward to doing with everyone there. At the end of the year, I'm looking forward to the career fair that we're going to be doing in May. That's an exciting opportunity to see what else is out there for our students, for personal reason, I'm looking forward to my granddaughter's first birthday.
All right.
Which will be here soon.
Me? Okay. I, too, am anxious to see what school's going to be for the next couple months. I'm sure with Miss Moretz being new to the building, we're going to see a lot of positive things take place. And I, in my personal life, I'm anxious to see what Reading High's basketball team is going to be like.
And I do have to add to that, Mrs. Fick, that, you know, it's not all about sports and basketball or football, but it was really nice to see Lonnie Walker and the team last year bring the city around to feeling positive and feeling really good about themselves and about everything else that we have in the city. And I think that takes off and makes everybody around that program just want to be something and be better and even more special. So I think that's really special too. We would have to think too, our prayers and our thoughts go out to those of Harvey and Irma coming up the coast now, coming closer to us. Mm-hmm. And I think that there's so much that we can do as a school, a school district, and so much we can do as people to help those in need down in those areas. I know that there's been some people I've been in touch with that they've been battling a lot. I had friends that lived here and they moved down there, and they're battling right now coming back. They don't have a house. And, you know, it's just nice to be able to see that maybe sometimes maybe we can help. And I know that just looking at this group here, we'd be willing to do that. So, and I always like to go out and reach out to the public. If anybody's listening tonight or if it's on playback, please tune in or call into the BCTV station and see how you can hook up with the City Kids TV show, because that is important. There's a lot of times I'd like to reach out and do more of that, but I can't always do that. So you have to call in as well. So Anthony, some final thoughts here. I see our flash in 2 minutes, so some final thoughts for you and things that you're going to be looking forward to?
Well, I mean, I like to see this type of interview with young to old. No,
thank you, Anthony.
You didn't really mean old. You didn't mean old, but that's how it came out.
But yeah, I like to see that, and I like to see like the steps through life and, you know, being successful.
Mm-hmm. And I always use it as a journey. You know, we're on a journey in our life that we have those bumps and those bruises, but it's a journey that we all are on, and we're going one way or another that we're on that journey, you know. So I think that we have a lot to be thankful for in the city and with all the things that we do here. So if you have any thoughts, anybody have any other thoughts that you would want to pass on before we say goodnight?
Just appreciate you having us. And right. It's yes. been very interesting hearing mm-hmm. the experiences, and thank you.
I've learned a lot from just getting to know Ms. Moretz as our vice principal and getting to know a little bit about your background as well. And I look forward to having a lot of success at our school. And because I am at Northeast, I'm going to do a shout out to Mr. Brown. He's always someone that works very hard at his job. He's there early mornings, 6 a.m., and as far as I know, and he's there very late in the afternoon some days. So, and I see you doing the same thing, Ms. Moretz, that we are dedicated to our job, and we love what we do. So, Anthony, I think that you will be successful in your new endeavor of running, right? You're doing your running, and mm-hmm. You have a meet, you said, what, up in New York?
No, that's a little far into the season. But.
Oh, far into the season. Okay, so you're going to be running 3 miles, and that's more than I can do. A lot more.
Yeah.
So, ladies, thank you. Gentlemen, thank you again for being here this evening. And again, if anybody can reach out to us through BCTV, please do so. And Anthony?
Thank you for tuning in to City Kids Making a Difference. And until next month, have a good night.